I'm here today to introduce a series of videos that we are going to be taking from the program called Business Intelligence and Data Analytics. So students will be showcasing the various material that they are engaged in this program. It's an honors program, it's a new program. So we just want to show you what we are all about. And this first video of the series that we are holding is on data mining. So we are going to be taught how to mine data. What does data mining mean in the first place? And how it can help businesses to make huge profits and retain their employees. Thank you very much.
Hi everyone, this is Lanet Sale, a Business Intelligence and Data Analytics student here in the Botswana Accountancy College down in Africa. Well, today I will be talking to you about big data analytics. First, have you ever wondered where all the data you use every day comes from or what it does? I mean, like from your emails to your social networks to your images and even audios. Well, they make up what we call big data. Big data is data sets that are so voluminous and complex that traditional data processing application software are inadequate to deal with. This is to say, big data is massive amounts of data, not just any other data, but unstructured data, which makes it even more complex. Unstructured data here, we are talking about data with different patterns, for example, your audio files, images, your texts, and so on. So with all these different data types, it's so complex to deal with them from the analytical point of view. Hence, we have this, which is the complexity of big data. And big data alone is useless, regardless of its type, size, or speed. Hence, that's why we need big analytics. So big data plus analytics, we get value. Hence, here, now we will move on to the V's, which define big data analytics. Now, we need to understand that big data analytics is basically manipulating big data in order to get information from the data, which is useful to organizations, which will influence them in decision making and so on and so forth. Now, the V's that define big data analytics. First, we have volume. Volume here, we are basically talking about the amount of data which goes in, the amount of data which organizations deal with. And for example, first we have volume, which in this case we are looking at the amount of data which is being produced. Now, if we take, for example, YouTube alone has 300 hours of video being uploaded every minute. So you can imagine the amount of data which flows in every minute from all other sources, looking at your texts, your emails, and everything else. And then secondly, we have velocity, which is the speed at which data has been generated, produced, created, or refreshed. An example can be of Google. It processes on average of more than 40,000 search queries every second, which roughly translates to more than 3.5 billion searches per day. So you can imagine the amount of data which has been put in that. So we have now veracity, which refers more to the provenance or reliability of the data source, its context, and how meaningful it is to the analysis on it. So veracity, it's basically the confidence or the trust we have in the data. Now, for example, we can consider a data set of statistics on how people purchase at restaurants and these item prices over the past 5 years. Now, questions you might ask yourself is, who created the source? What methodology did they follow in collecting the data? Were only certain cuisines or restaurants included? And the creator summarized the data, and has the information been edited or modified by anyone else? So answers to these questions are necessary to determine whether the veracity of this information to determine rather the veracity of this information. Knowledge of the data's veracity in turn help us better understand the risks and the risks associated with analysis and business decisions based on this particular data set. Hence, veracity is very important. And you should note that as the other V's, as the other factors increase, this one rather decreases, because if you have more and more volume, more and more sums of data and everything else, then the trust and confidence you have in that data tend to decrease. Hence, this is also very important. And then we have variability. In the context of big data, it refers to a few things. One is the number of inconsistencies in the data. Well, it can also refer to the number of inconsistencies in the speed at which data is being loaded into your database. And then, lastly but not least, we have value, which is the most important of them all. All these other V's mentioned are useless unless you can derive business value from it. Hence, we should take note that value, without value, then big data is rather useless. And hence, that's why we said big data plus big analytics equals to great value. Now, we'll move on to the importance of big data analytics. Big data analytics helps organizations harness their data and use it to identify new opportunities. This leads to smarter business moves, more efficient operations, higher profits, and happier customers. And so you can tell that with big data analytics, you would never go wrong. Now, you might wonder, who's really using this big data analytics? And how do they use it? First, we have organizations in the healthcare sector. Well, big data is rather a given in the healthcare sector. Patient records, health plans, insurance information, and other types of information can be difficult to manage, but are full of insights once analytics are applied. That's why big data analytics technology is so important to healthcare. By analyzing the amount of data quickly, healthcare providers can provide life-saving diagnosis or treatment options almost immediately. Hence, it's very important to save people and rather not let them to die. And then we have travel and hospitality. Well, in the travel and hospitality sector, we know that keeping customers happy is key. But sometimes, customer satisfaction can be hard to gauge, especially in a timely manner. Resorts and casinos, for example, have only a short window of opportunity to turn around a customer experience that's going south really fast. Yes, big data analytics gives these businesses the ability to collect customer data, apply analytics, and immediately identify potential problems before it's too late. So if they still want to make money and if they still want to make their customers happy, they have to apply big data analytics. And lastly but not least, we have the retail. Customer service has evolved in the past several years. As savvier shoppers expect retailers to understand exactly what they need and when they need it. Big data analytics technology helps retailers meet those demands. Armed with endless amounts of data from customer loyalty programs, buying habits, and other sources, retailers not only have an in-depth understanding of their customers, they can also predict trends, recommend new products, and boost profitability. So, now, if retailers really want to keep their customers happy and everything else, they should always know big data analytics is the way. Now, one may wonder, what are the key successes of big data analytics? What needs to be done in order to make big data a success? Well, first you need a clear business need, because certainly you can't just analyze your data without really knowing what you really need it for. And secondly, you need strong committed sponsorship money talks these days, hence you need loyalty and sponsorship from people in high places. And then we have to align, there should be an alignment between the business and IT strategy. And then a fact-based decision-making culture, because we don't want people tomorrow to storm up thinking that you've made your decisions based on lies, not on truth. So a fact-based decision-making culture is very significant in this case. And then you need a strong data infrastructure. You're dealing with large amounts of data here, so you need something really strong to contain that data. And then we have the right, you have to have the right analytical tools. You can't just analyze data without having the right analytical tools, or else you think that big data analytics is kind of useless without having them. So right analytical tools are very important. And then lastly but not least, you have to have personnel with advanced analytical skills. So it's so useless to have all these things without having people who can use them. Hence, you really need people with skills. And with all these, ladies and gentlemen, you have keys to success with big data analytics. Now, big data analytics with the evolvement of big data analytics, there are certain business problems which have been addressed. I'll just list them and not dive much into them. First, we have enhanced customer experience, identify new products and market opportunities, risk management, enhanced security capabilities, and process efficiency and cost reduction. Now, I know that one may think that everything is so holy with big data analytics that there are no problems. Well, they are. Looking at the fact that with the evolving of big data analytics, and even though problems have been solved, it has come with challenges itself. Excuse me. First, we have the challenge of data volume. Here, we're dealing with large amounts of data, and you should have the right infrastructure to contain that data. Secondly, we have data integration, data governance, and skill availability and process capabilities. All these things have are challenges which have been brought about by big data analytics and which need to be curbed before it's too late. Now, one may wonder, how do you really get to analyze this data? What do you use? Do you just come and look at your data and think and just use your human mind thinking that you can analyze it on your own? No, that's not how it happens. We have big data technologies which are used to rather analyze and do everything that which is necessary in the data. Now, we have plenty of big data technologies, and here we'll only dwell in two. First, we have the Hive, the Pig, the H-Base, Uzi, Ambari, Avro, and Flu, and many more. But in this video, we'll just talk about MapReduce and Hadoop. First, we have MapReduce, which its aim is at achieving high performance with simple computers. It's good at processing and analyzing large volumes of multi-structured data in a timely manner. So one can just say it deals with distributing the processing of very large multi-structured data files across the structure of ordinary machines or processors. Now, MapReduce was developed and popularized by Google. Secondly, we have Hadoop, which is an open source framework for storing and analyzing massive amounts of distributed and structured data. It runs on inexpensive commodity hardware, so projects can scale out inexpensively. Originally, it was created by Doug Kuching at Yahoo, but now it's part of the Apache Software Foundation. Now, MapReduce plus Hadoop equals to big data core technology. So with these two, you have to really understand them in depth so that you can really know the core technology involved in big data. Now, you should know one thing, that Hadoop and MapReduce are related, but they're not the same. MapReduce provides control for analytics, not analytics. And Hadoop is about data diversity, not just data volume. Now, as an aspiring data scientist, you should know how to succeed with big data analytics. First, you have to simplify your data, like make it as simple as possible. You just have to keep it simple. Secondly, you should govern, integrate, empower, visualize, and evangelize. Not going around preaching the gospel, but no, sharing what you have with those who do not know it. And hence, that's the end of today's presentation. Catch us next time with more.